should be calm, does not like that. So, okay, Sabana, I have admitted. So, I think I got almost all students, ma. Most of them have joined. So, good morning, everyone. So, welcome to today's
morning, sir.
Session. Morning.
Morning, sir.
Welcome to good morning. Good morning. So, we are going to start our session today. Today's topic. So, I am going to start about a topic which I have already given introduction part. So, we are going to study about the
remaining questions, sir.
Remaining questions, if anyone have doubt, you can ask me, or else if you want me to do what you say, solution, and send me, I'll be able to send a solution. If you have any questions, you can come up with me, ma. Or else if you want me to write what you say, the question answers, and I'll send to you. Which is
okay, sir.
Which is preferable? Why? Because again,
yes,
if I sit on question paper discussion, even half of the time will go on it. Can I do that part? But I won't write questions, but I'll write the answers and I'll take a pick and I'll send to you. If you have any doubts on that part, you can ask me, right? Is it clear?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, like, theory questions are there, like xenon fluorides, hydrolyzed. So, that part I won't write. Rest of the part, even the questions which I have discussed yesterday also, I'll send. Clear? But it will not be so, what you say, like, printed form or something else. But I'll... my handwritten part will be there. Try to adjust with that. If you have any doubts, sir, I couldn't understand how to answer this question means, you can ask me, so that I'll be happy to help you in that. Clear? So shall we start our session? Why? Because if I keep on doing that again, it will be dragging, ma. I want to complete this VBT. I'm so eager to start about organic. Right. So here itself, I will give more amount of data when I start VBT. So try to make notes, as my writing will not be as fast as on board. I won't give separate time. You can write down simultaneously. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. But don't chat there. Why? Because I am not using the window to see your chat. So you can unmute and you can speak. So, like, we are studying about bonding. A study about bonding in coordination compounds. Now,
so screen.
Screen sharing, I didn't on up to now I didn't started screen sharing. Very good.
Yes.
Thank you. I have written something also on the shared part. Thank you. I think you are able to see now. Thank you, ma, for reminding me. Gentle reminder. Okay. Bonding in coordination compounds, we are going to study. Now, entering into part. So, here, what will happen is coordinate covalent bond. Coordinate, I have explained in detail, ma, is coordinate covalent bond. I just give the postulates and I will go into the examples. Coordinate covalent bond is formed by overlapping of atomic orbitals. Overlapping of atomic orbitals. Which atomic orbitals are these? These are atomic orbitals of ligands. These are atomic orbitals of ligands and central metal atom. Someone wants to join, I'll admit them. Okay. So these both atomic orbitals should overlap. Suppose this is my central metal atom. This is my central metal atom. So suppose here is a ligand. This ligand orbital, this ligand will give electrons to metal. If I take trigonal planar geometry, this will be like this. I hope you understood why I am writing the arrow marks like this. If I write arrow mark like this, I am representing which bond? Coordinate covalent bond. The specialty of coordinate covalent bond is, here one atom will give two electrons. One atom only gives the two electrons. One atom gives two electrons. Gives two electrons. Now, see, if this is ligand orbital, imagine this is ligand orbital, it will be having electron pairs. Electron pairs will be there. Now, as it is giving two electrons, as it is giving electron, now this is ligand orbital, ligand, not able to write, ligand orbital. As we know, each orbital can accommodate orbital. I hope I have very clearly explained this. Each orbital can accommodate. Why we cannot accommodate three electrons in an orbital, children? Have clearly explained in earlier. Why? Because it will violate Pauli's exclusion principle. Are you able to recollect it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now look here. See, this is ligand orbital. This ligand is having electron pairs. Sorry, the central. Correct. This is ligand. It is having electron pair. Sorry, this is central metal atom. Central metal atom. Now this orbital of ligand, that's what I'm saying. A coordinate covalent bond is found by overlapping of atomic orbitals of ligands with central metal atom. As ligand is giving two electrons, central metal atom should have vacant orbitals. We cannot say central metal atom can have one electron. No, it will not work. Why? Because it's a covalent bond. It's a covalent bond. Each orbital will be having one electron and they will share those two electrons. But that will not work in coordinate covalent bond. Why? Because both the electrons will be given by one atom. So other atoms should have vacant orbital. So these both will overlap. This is ligand orbital. This is central metal atom atom. Central metal atom orbitals. So after overlapping, after they will share this electron. Are you following me? Any doubts up to here?
No, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Now, so I'm saying the ligand orbitals and central metal atom orbitals will overlap. Orbitals will overlap. Before overlapping, the central metal atom orbitals will undergo hybridization. That means what I am saying, these both should overlap. Before overlapping, this central metal atom will undergo hybridization. Is it clear? It undergo hybridization. Now, hybridization means intermixing of orbitals. Hybridization means intermixing. It is not combined. Overlapping means like this. Intermixing means both will be combined like this. Right. So, central metal atom orbitals will undergo hybridization. Central metal atom. Central metal atom will undergo hybridization. Is it clear up to here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now the question is, can I take new page, ma?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Don't save. Okay. Now, what we are studying is which orbital our central metal atom is using. The central metal atom uses s orbital. The central metal atom uses s orbital, p orbital, and n minus 1 d orbital. This type, one more type is, it can use s orbital, p orbital, and d orbital and d orbital. Sir, here you have written n minus 1 d. Here you have written d. What is the difference? I'll say, suppose I'll take this is 3d 4s 4p. This can undergo hybridization. That means 1d orbital of c. I am arranging shells not in order of energies. I am not arranging shells in the order of energy. I am arranging shells in order of their radius. Order of radius. Now when I take 3d and 4s, which will be having more radius, ma? Which will be having more radius? Answer fast.
3d.
No. 4s will be having more radius. See, as n value increases, radius also will increase. But when I compare energy, 3d will be having more energy than 4s. That is why we will be writing 3d, 4s and 4p. Sorry, we will write same 4s, then we will write 3d, then we will write 4p. This is order of energy, n plus l value. This also I have explained. But now what I am doing is, I am not arranging the orbitals in energy, rather I am arranging in order of radius. So I am writing 3d, 4s, 4p. Now when I come here, 4s, 4p, 4d, 3d will be here. If in hybridization, if 3d is used, I'll write n minus 1 into d. If in hybridization 4d is used along with 4s, I'll write d orbital. Any doubt in this part?
No.
Okay. So your central metal atom, whatever you want to call. So the central metal atoms is using s, p and n minus 1 into d and s, p and d orbitals for hybridization. After hybridization, overlapping will take place. Between what and what overlapping will take place? Can you answer? Answer first. Between what and what overlapping will take place? Between
40.
Hybrid orbitals of central metal atom. Central metal atom is only undergoing hybridization. After hybridization, overlapping of hybrid orbitals of central metal atom and ligands takes place and bond will be formed. Understood what I have concised?
Yes, sir.
So, central metal atom is undergoing hybridization and
yes,
it is using. Okay, thank you. Central metal atom is undergoing hybridization and it is using this orbital. So, the central metal atom will undergo hybridization. After hybridization, these hybrid orbitals will overlap with ligands orbitals. But here I have given a condition. What is the condition? Is this central metal atom orbital should be empty. Now here I'll try to give a logic, children. Can I take new page?
Yes,
can I take new page? Now this is what the crucial part in cancel. I'm trying to save it now. Here crucial part is, how many orbitals will involve in hybridization? How many orbitals? Third point I'm saying, how many orbitals is required for hybridization? How many orbitals are necessary for hybridization? Now here I'll give you a logic, children. This is crucial part. If you are not able to understand, ask me. Suppose suppose I'll write a complex here. Ag NH3 twice. Ag NH3 twice. Let's get it. Now, silver should undergo which one? Hybridization. Silver atom should undergo hybridization, and that atomic orbitals which has undergone hybridization will overlap with ligands. Ligands will bring electron. So how many orbitals should undergo hybridization? How many orbitals should undergo hybridization? These orbitals, condition is these orbitals should be empty. These orbitals should be empty. Why? Because ligand will give two electrons. These orbitals should be empty. Condition, I'm saying, how many orbitals should undergo hybridization is equal to number of electron pairs donated by ligands. Electron pair donated by ligands. Donated by ligands. Now, in this example, children, in this example, how many electron pairs will be donated by ligands, ma? Now, how many ligands are there? Two ligands. What are those? NH3. Each NH3 will give how many electrons? This is a monodentate ligand, right? It will give one electron pair. This will also give one electron pair. I'm using word called as pair. So, how many pairs are coming? How many electron pairs are donating here? These ligands. Answer fast. Two. So, how many hybrid orbitals are required? How many hybrid orbitals are required? Two. See, orbitals required for hybridization, orbitals should undergo. How many orbitals should undergo hybridization? The orbitals should undergo hybridization is equal to number of electron pair donated by ligand. Here, how many ligands are coming? Two ligands. Each ligand can give two electrons, that means one pair. I should accommodate two electron pairs in central metal atom. One orbital can accommodate one electron pair. So I require two hybrid orbitals. What are those two hybrid orbitals? One is S and other is P. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now I'll try to ask you a few questions. Sir. I'll try to ask you a few questions. Try to answer this. NiCl4, 2-. Now my question is, how many hybrid orbitals are required? Past
one, sir.
Think and say, how many hybrid orbitals are required? Now, how many ligands are coming? How many ligands are coming? Answer. How many ligands are coming?
Four, sir.
Four ligands are coming. Each ligand will give how many electron pairs? Each ligand.
One
electron pair. So, totally how many electron pairs are donated to central metal atom? Totally how many electron pairs? Totally how many electron pairs are donated by ligand to central metal atom? Answer? Four pairs. How many are there? Chlorines? Chloride ions? Four are there. Each chloride will donate two. Each chloride ion will donate two electrons. So four ligands are there. I require four hybrid orbitals. Are you following me?
Sir.
Yes. Yes. Okay. I'll check your. Can I take new page? Now I'll ask you questions. You should be able to say how many hybrid orbitals are required. Okay. Hg I3-. How many hybrid orbitals are required? Half central metal. Very good, ma. Rest of you, are you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Now say me, how many hybrid orbitals of central metal atoms are required? come on. This is CN. Correct. I'm happy at least you are able to recognize. Next one. FeCO5. How many hybrid orbitals are required?
Five, sir.
Very good, ma. Thank you. At least you are answering. I'll write one more. NiCN 5 times. How many hybrid orbitals we require? Answers fast.
Five, sir.
Thanks, ma. Very good. Good. Now you are able to understand what I am saying. So, the number of hybrid orbitals required will be equal to number of electron pair donated. If it is monodendrite ligand, we can directly say that is equal to number of ligands coming. If it is monodendrite, if monodendrite means we can directly say number of hybrid orbitals required. Hybrid orbitals required is equal to number of ligands. Equal to number of ligands. Understood up to here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is the use of VBT? Now we are going. What is the use of VBT? By VBT, we can say shape. We can say what? Shape of molecule, which was not explained by Werner. We can say shape of molecule, whether it is octahedral, square planar, or tetrahedral, or it is linear, or whatever it may be. We can say about its shape with the help of VBT. Then we can also determine about its, to say its shape, we require its hybridization. We require its hybridization. Suppose if coordination number is 2, how many hybrid orbitals we require, ma?
2, sir.
2. Very good. Why? Because if coordination number is 2, means I'll write here AG NH3 twice plus. Here coordination number is 2 means it require each NH3 is giving one lone pair. So totally two electron pairs are donated by ligand. So I require 2 hybrid orbitals. So I am writing, I require 2 hybrid orbitals. So what are those 2 hybrid orbitals? Those are SP. Coordination number 2, hybridization will be SP. If it is SP, its shape will be linear. Are you understanding what I am writing there?
Yes, sir.
Can I take new page? Children, yes, if you are not able to follow, say me, I will explain again. It's not a big deal for me. Right. If anyone is not able to understand, you can say me, sir, I'm not able to understand, means I'll explain. So I'll write here CN. Don't write CN like this, you write coordination number in your book. If it is 2, it is which hybridization? SP. Here we will get shape will be linear, bond angle will be 180. Here central metal atom, here one ligand will be there, here one ligand will be there. Understood?
Yes, sir.
If not, I can give examples also here. AG NH3 twice plus. Now coordination number 3. Now you have to say me now. Coordination number 3. So which hybridization it will be? SP2. If it is SP2, shape will be trigonal planar. Bond angle will be 120. The shape will be like this. Central metal atom here, one ligand here, another ligand here, another ligand here. Done. HgI3 minus. Now coordination number 4, it can be sp3. Four, no, see, look here, this one is 2p, totally 3. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
planner.
Okay. Thanks, ma. If it is coordination number is 4, it is SP3 hybridization, tetrahedral. Tetrahedral. Children, here I will teach entire concept of coordination like VBT. I won't say half here. Don't expect, sir, in competitive you say half there. It is not possible. It will be completely, the data will be given here. So be careful. So 4 means SP3. If SP3 means it will be having 109 degrees 28 minutes. So shape will be around like this, metal atom. Here one, here one, here one, here one. Here one ligand, here one ligand, here one ligand, here one ligand. I think you hope you are understanding why I am writing the arrow mark like this.
Yes, yes.
Right. Okay. So for that example, I can give as NiCO4. I will write example here. There is no space. NiCO4. Can you name this? Tetracarbonyl nickel 0. It is a neutral complex. I have given more practice on writing these names. Okay. Next, if hybridization, sorry, coordination number is 4, one more hybridization is possible. That is DSP2. DSP2. Here shape will be square planar. Square planar. Bond angle in square planar, it will be 90. It will be 90 degrees. Okay. If I want me to write the structure, it will be like this. Central metal atom will be here. Ligands will be like this. Understood, children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Bond angle will be 90. Now, here one ligand, 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 ligand. Next, here I can give example. NiCN4, 2 minus. Can you name this? Try. Tetra cyanido nickelate 2 ion. Understood? No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Study, children. So, coordination number 5. See. Actually, this is very tricky, ma. In entire coordination compounds, coordination number 5 is tricky. So it has two different types of hybridization. One type, I'll write shortcut. You don't write shortcut. What is this TBP? Trigonal bipyramidal. Very good. So this shape will be like this. Here ligand will be giving electron, ligand, ligand, top one ligand, bottom one ligand. Here these both are called as axial bonds. Their bond angle will be 90 degrees. Here bond angle are called as equatorial bond, that is 120. These are called as which type of bonds? Axial bonds. These are called as equatorial bonds. Understood?
Yes,
sir. Okay. See, if coordination number 5, one more type of hybridization will be there. One more type of hybridization will be there. That is DSP3. DSP3. If it is DSP3, it's a... Sorry, I have written SP3D, right? SP3D. One second, ma. DSP3. If it is DSP3, here we cannot predict shape based on hybridization. That is what I am saying. Exception. We can make mark exception.
Yes,
we cannot say what is exception. We cannot say shape based on hybridization. This one. So one more type of hybridization is there, is DSP3. So it can show a shape called as Square pyramidal. Square pyramidal. Square pyramidal. I have given an indication. This is an exception based on hybridization. We cannot predict the shape. This one. This is a different case. Can I proceed?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Now, if it is square planar, square pyramidal means it will be like this. Now, I'll write small shape. Here one ligand, on top one ligand will be there. This is square pyramidal. Understood? If you are joining like this, you'll get which shape? Square pyramidal. Understood? These four on one plane, one is on top. So here bond angle will be 90. Here bond angles will be 90. In square pyramidal, bond angles will be 90. Done, ma. So here, what is the exception is based on in five, based on hybridization, cannot predict shape. SP3D, it can be trigonal bipyramidal, it can be square pyramidal. Both possibilities are there. This is exception. Now last one is 6. If coordination number is 6, can you answer now what hybridization it might have?
Square bipyramidal.
No, take your time. I'll give one more chance. Use one more chance. Say about its shape. Octahedral. Octahedral. Now hybridization will be D2SP3 octahedral. So here octahedral means, see, this is square pyramidal, right? I'll write one more which is down. It will become octahedral. You want me to explain this octahedral in new page? I'll explain. Or else, okay sir, we are able to understand here means when I take each one example, I'll take one example and I'll make you understand. If you think it is clear, sir, here octahedral means, I'll take direct example there when I'm teaching, I'll explain it. Your wish, say fast. You want me to write it separately, octahedral complex?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for your answers. New. We want everything new, right? Everything we want new. New page. Take new page. Each day is a new day for us. So every day we have new opportunities. We have to use those opportunities. So don't think, sir, today opportunity is to eat and sleep and repeat. Okay. Coordination number is 6. Hybridization will be D2SP3. Can you say its shape? Just now I said no.
Octahedral.
Okay, good. It is octahedral complex. Octahedral complex. Now, how does this octahedral complex will resemble, sir? Ting. This is right square planar, simply. Okay, I messed up. This is same. Aira, no one are talking. Sorry, you are recording, sir. That's why you are not talking. If recording is there only, you should talk more. It's not my policy, my school policy. So this is about octahedral complex. See this. I'll take different color. This one are in plane or on the plane. I'll take different color. This one are on top and bottom. See, this and this are top and bottom. So here bond angles will be 90 degrees. Bond angles will be 90. All the bonds, it will be 90 degrees. Octahedral complex. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So now I'll discuss.
Sir, why can't that be square bipyramidal?
Square bipyramidal. Can you draw that structure square bipyramidal? How it looks? You can.
Sir, two axial bonds and four equatorial bonds, sir.
Two axial. So you want
four
to
place equatorials.
Here four equatorials are there, no? 1, 2, 3, 4. These four are equatorial. This and this is axial.
Is there same number of bonds are for a square by pyramidal, no sir?
Square, see, we don't have square bipyramidal, we have square pyramidal. See, this is square pyramidal. Now this is one ligand here, one ligand here, one ligand here, one ligand here, and one ligand from top. This is, if this is central metal atom, this is one ligand, this another ligand, this another ligand, this another ligand, this another ligand. So this shape is called a square pyramidal only. Square pyramidal. That means, see how we'll get this. Join this. I got square pyramidal. Suppose if I place one more ligand here, if I join this one, it will become octahedral. That is what this shape. Understood?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So if I, this is square pyramidal. If I place one more down, if I join, I'll get octahedral. I won't get bipyramidal. I'll get pyramidal. One pyramidal will get. Done? Yes or no?
Okay, sir.
Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So we'll study in detail 1-1 complex. See, this VBT is not complete, ma. VBT is not complete. Before only I'm saying it's not complete. We require some additional data. So when it is when it comes, I will make you understand why require additional data to predict hybridization. To predict, even I can write here, to predict hybridization. So if you have your NCRTs with you, you can open VBT there, it will be written. To predict hybridization, we require some additional data, like magnetic momentum, hybridization, additional data we want. What is that additional data? They should provide its magnetic nature or its magnetic nature unpaired. They should specify this. If they are not specify this, VBT is useless. Are you understanding what I am saying? There is a disadvantage in VBT. What is the disadvantage in VBT? Is we cannot predict hybridization unless they provide some additional data. What is that additional data? Is they should provide either magnetic nature or unpaired electrons. Then only we can do. Magnetic nature means either they will say it is paramagnetic or diamagnetic. It is paramagnetic or diamagnetic. Or else they can say its magnetic momentum is 1.73 bm. If it is 1.73 bm, it will be having one unpaired electrons. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, to predict hybridization, even I am saying the disadvantage of VBT, to predict hybridization, we require some additional data. That is, they should at least say which para, either it is paramagnetic or diamagnetic, or else they can say, or else they'll say it is unpaired, or else they'll say it is paired electrons. These are data, or else they'll give this, what you say,
magnetic momentum.
Based on magnetic momentum, we can calculate how many unpaired electrons are there. Do you remember that formula to calculate magnetic momentum? Can someone say?
Root over of n into n plus 2.
Good, bruh. Here n is equal to number of unpaired electrons. Number of unpaired electrons. If this data is not given, we cannot use VBT. VBT is useless. So to overcome that CFT came. Which is called as crystal field theory. So going into this, understood up to here now, I hope?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'll start with one by one coordination number 2. Coordination number 2. Coordination number 2. So same fast, what's its hybridization if coordination number is 2? What hybridization, Ra?
SP, sir.
Very good, Ma. What's its shape?
Linear.
Very good. What is its bond angle?
180 degrees.
Very good. Now look here. In this, I'll take the example of AgNH3 twice. You can also take AgCN twice also. Now look here. What is the central metal atom here? Ag. Calculate so Ag. Ag. Electronic configuration of Ag. So I am going to write its electronic configuration of Ag. The electronic configuration of Ag will be 4d10 5s1. Sir, you have written Ag configuration very confidently, sir. How we will remember this Ag configuration? Means nothing. See. So we know 11th group, copper, silver, gold. These all belong to one group, which are called as coinage metals. This belong to 11th group. This group will be having similar configuration. Can you say me copper configuration? Copper configuration. 3d10 4s1. Yes or no? Any doubts here?
No, sir. Fine, sir.
Copper configuration is 3d10 4s1. Now, what will be the silver configuration? It will be 4d10 5s1. Understood? So, that is why I have written directly. So, that is the logic how we can remember. If you remember, elements from scandium to zinc, electronic configuration, that is possible to predict electronic configuration for rest of the elements. There will be some, changes, but that is sufficient. Right. Now, so this is silver configuration I have written. Now, silver is, and what is the oxygen state of silver, Ma? Pash, what is the oxygen state of silver here?
2, sir.
1, sir.
1, Ra. Ag plus 1. This is 0, right? X plus 0 is equal to plus 1. So, silver configuration is plus 1. Now, I have to remove electrons. From where I will remove electrons? From 4d10 or 5s1. Plus 1 means it is losing electron. From which orbital I should remove electron?
5.
Why? Because outer. I have to remove electron from outer only. I cannot remove from inner. So, I will remove this one. So, it is having what configuration now? 4d10. 5s0. Very good. Now, say me, how many hybrid orbitals we require for this? Ray, from coordination number, Sarah, how many hybrid orbitals we require from central metal atom?
2.
Very good. Now, that 2 should be vacant. This is 5s0. This is 4d10. Can I use 4d10 orbitals for hybridization? Hybridization, it is not hybridization can occur between empty orbitals, even filled orbitals also hybridization can occur. Unpaired electrons also can occur. But here, for coordinate covalent bond, this phenomena will not occur. For coordinate covalent bond, I want empty orbitals. So I cannot use 3D orbitals. Are you following me what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
For hybridization, I require empty orbitals. Why? Because ligand will give 2 electrons. So, here only one empty orbital is there. After 5s, what will be there? 5p will be there. I am writing this in increase in radius, not about energy. I have said after 5s, 5p will be there. After 5p, which will be there? 5d will be there. I am not writing it based on energies. I am writing it based on radius. Is it clear? See, 4D. After 4D, 5S will be there. After 5S, 5P will be there. After 5S, 5P will be there. Understood? These are empty. This is 0. It does not have electron. This also does not have electron. Any doubt in this one, Ma? I require how many hybrid orbitals? I require 2. That is why 1s orbital of 5s and 1p orbital of 5p will undergo hybridization, and it is going to form sp. This is no more s now, it has intermixed. This is sp hybrid orbital, this is sp hybrid orbital. Now, this NH3 will come here. this NH3 will come here. This NH3 will give two electrons. This NH3, one more NH3 will give, it also gives two electrons to this two hybrid orbitals. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Clear? Anyone have doubts, ma? Anyone have doubts in this?
No, sir.
Okay. Its shape will be like this, NH3.
No, sir.
Here one. Thank you, ma. And another NH3. Bond angle is 180. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can I go for next one, next coordination number?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir. You can also remember its atomic number will be 47. Silver. Atomic number will be 47. Atomic mass will be 108. Atomic mass will be 108. Simple thing. I'll try to use so that some other time it may be useful for you. You won't study it independently. That's why I'm using atomic numbers and atomic masses there. Right. Now I'm going to deal with coordination number 3. Same in coordination number 3, how many hybrid orbitals are required? Say fast, ma.
3, sir.
3, sir.
Very good. I am so happy for your answers. So I have written this. Now, Mercury. I want to write about Mercury configuration. I want to write Mercury configuration. So to write Mercury configuration, even I can say atomic number of Mercury is 80. Sir, you are confusing us, sir. Don't say all these atomic numbers and all. Remember just, right? Try to remember. So when it is required, you can recollect it. Now, I have tried its configuration. How I know configurations are 80? Should I write 80 electrons? Not required. See, this belongs to 12th group. Zinc, cadmium, mercury. What is configuration for zinc, ma?
3d10 4s2.
Now say for mercury. Come on. This will be
6s2 5d10, sir.
Correct. This is 4d10 5s2. This is 5d10 6s2. Excellent. Good answer. So it will become 5d10 6s2. Now calculate mercury hybridization. Sorry, oxidation state. Fast, jaldi, sigram.
2, sir.
2, sir.
Very good. So Hg plus 2. From SRD.
Yes. From where?
Very good. So it will become 5D.
10, 6, 6, 0.
Very good, ma. Now, how many unpaired 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? So I'll fill electrons. Okay, this is 5d10. Is 6s is having electrons now?
No, sir.
It does not have electrons, it has lost. Okay. After Gudra, after 6s, what will be there, say? What orbital will be there? 6s?
6p, sir.
Very good. 6s and 6p. After 6p, what will come? 6d will come. It will be 6d. All will be having 0, 0 electrons. All will be having 0, 0 electrons. Why it is not filled? Now, we require how many hybrid orbitals, ma? Say fast.
3, sir.
Very good. How many hybrid orbitals? We require 3. Now, which orbitals I should use, say?
3, sir.
Which orbitals I should use for hybridization?
Yes, P2, sir.
Very good. 1s and 2p will undergo hybridization. Now, this is no more s. This is sp2 hybrid orbital. This is also sp2.
2p.
This is also sp2. Now, hybridization means intermixing. I cannot call this as independently as x. I cannot call this as independently as p. Now, this is sp2. This is sp2. This is sp2. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, these empty orbitals will overlap with iodine. Here one iodine will come. It will give two electrons here. Another iodine, it will give two electrons here. another iodine, it will give two electrons. So it is having which hybridization? sp2 hybridization. This look like this, ma. Hg, here one iodine, here one iodine, here one iodine. Can we say bond angles
120 degrees?
Yes, it is 120 degrees hybridization is sp2. Any doubts up to here?
No, sir.
So shall we meet, what you say, tomorrow? Any doubt?